Hi everyone, it's Tyrone from tyroneshum.com. In today's video tutorial, I want to show you my three top productivity and time-saving tools that I use in my business. And I've been getting a lot of people asking me this question is, how can I save a lot of things being mobile and save it all online? So I thought, let's just look at some really, really good applications that I use day-to-day and helps me save everything. The reason being is just in case you lose your laptop or you might lose your data on your laptop, everything will be all backed up online or saved online, therefore allowing you to have a so-called paperless office. For me, I try to keep everything at a minimal, so that's why I try to have all my papers and everything that notes and stuff like that loose all put online. Alright, let's have a look. First thing I want to show you today is the software called Evernote, which you can go to www.evernote.com. And it's a really, really neat piece of tool. It's an online-based tool, but you can also install it both on PC and also on Mac, and it allows you to also have a desktop application. It's the reason behind Evernote is that what happens is that anything that you want to capture, either via camera, via scanned document, or even capturing onto from a website, you can put it all into Evernote, and you'll never ever have to, per se, write anything down. Everything's all put online. And it allows you to store quite a lot of things all online for free. All right, so to download Evernote, all you have to do is just click on here. This says download now, and they'll allow you to download Evernote. I'm going to show you a quick demo of how it works and how easy it is. Let's just say, for example, I want to save a little blog post on Evernote. So I'll go to my blog. All right, let's go straight down to the bottom. Say, for example, down here. All right, say, for example, I was wanting to save all this text that's here that you can see. With Evernote, all you have to do is, once Evernote's been installed, just open it up and go clip screenshot into Evernote. And what it'll do is ask you to drag a proportion of it and select it. So I'll select that whole area there that I want to save. Once it's done that, I'll click OK. And in a few seconds, you'll have it snipped straight into Evernote and it's all saved online. There you go. You can see right there. So instead of saving a whole website or a whole page, you just only snip off whatever you need to be saved. And you can put that all in there. So let's just say this is PLF 3.0. Also, the great thing about this piece of software is that it allows you to search in between. So for example, if I was to type in Jeff Walker as a search term, Evernote knows how to search inside your notes and find exactly the information. Therefore, it makes it so easy to be able to find and search for data, and you won't have any loose notes lying around. So I've saved it as well. Let's say, for example, I want to search 4-hour work week. That's the one there. I've got that. So I'll just type it up here on the side. There you go. And as you can see, it comes up straight away. Anything we say YouTube in it, see that? Bang, it comes straight up. And that's how easy it is. I love this little piece of software because you can save lots and lots of stuff inside Evernote, and therefore you won't have to store it on a piece of paper. If you've got a scanner, just scan all the documents in there. And ideally, what I would use Evernote for is to scan any documents that you don't need to be kept in a folder anymore. Put it all in Evernote and allow it to be stored in there, and then you can easily search it through instead of having to go through a filing cabinet. So this is a really, really neat tool and really easy to use tool that you can use day to day. So check it out. Okay, the next piece of tool that I highly, highly recommend and I use every day is LastPass. LastPass is an automatic password filler for you. This saves you ample amount of time. And if you've got hundreds and hundreds of passwords like I do, it's the best application that you can find that will save all those, rather than saving into a spreadsheet or saving into anything else like another software. It's just so much easy. And what you'll find is, if you want to, say for example, add in your password to access your Gmail account or anything that requires a login and a password, this will automatically fill it in for you. All you have to do is simply just download LastPass right here, and what will happen is that once it's downloaded, it will install this application right here. And once it's installed onto your browser, it will automatically help you fill in your passwords. And I'll show you how easy it is right now, and I'll log into just a sample account. All right, so I'm going to log right into, say for example, my Google account here. And all I have to do is just press the up and down key and allow me to scroll through all the different usernames and passwords, whichever fits right. Okay, so once it's done that and you're happy with that, all you have to do is simply click sign in. And what happens is that it'll automatically sign you in. So therefore, you don't have to remember anything, which is good in many ways and also much more productive and fast. And all you need is just one main password, which will ask when you log in to your browser. And that's all you have to do. This is a time productive saving tool. And you just need to install this if you're going to be keeping all your passwords and everything all saved in one location. The next tool that I want to show you is called Freedom. And Freedom's an awesome little piece of software. If you're like me, who gets distracted quite easily from the internet, I can guarantee you that this software will stop you from doing that. Freedom is a software which restricts access to your internet browser and network access to anything, and allows you just to focus solely on the task that you're doing right now. Say, for example, if you need to crank out and write out an article, which will take you an hour or 2 hours to write out, or less than that, Freedom blocks off any internet access, any network access, so that you don't get distracted. And the only way for you to be able to access the internet again is for you to reboot your computer. Now, it's a bit frustrating. If you're in the middle of a task and then you have to get access to your internet because you need to browse for something or you just want to procrastinate, then to reboot is really, really annoying. So it forces you just to continue to stay productive and focus on your work. And you can have it scheduled up to anywhere up to 180 minutes or even 8 hours, actually, it says here. So 480 minutes. So you can download this just directly here, both in Mac version and also XP, Windows XP version or Windows 7 version, and just install it onto your computer. The trial version allows you to use it up to 5 times, and then after that, you've just got to pay for a full version, which is only $10. So for something that will save you time and productivity, this is an excellent piece of software, and I've been using it myself as well to stop me from hopping onto the internet and just focus on what I need to do. And this is great for writing articles or great for doing anything that you need to focus your productivity on. So give it a go. These are the 3 top tools that I recommend to give a trial out, because these things really, really help increase the productivity of my business. Watch out for the next video. I'll be showing you some more tools that I've got that will help you increase and also save your time as well too. So hopefully you've liked these tools that I've just recommended. These are just so far the top 3 that I've got here. If you've got any comments, feedback, or you'd like to tweet about this or put it on Facebook, feel free to do so. I'd love to hear your feedback and comments. And yeah, talk to you guys soon. It's Tyrone from tyroneshum.com. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next video.